So we define what electric flux is. Electric flux is a measure of the number of field lines that are crossing a given area. The fundamental formula for electric flux is E dot dA. Okay. Now in different situations, depending on the direction of electric field and the area vector, and using different mathematical tools, you can find out the flux through that area. Then we also define what Gauss law is, which is charge enclosed upon epsilon naught. Based on the Gauss law, we could find out the electric field by simply applying Gauss law, taking Gauss law as more fundamental than the Coulomb's law. So we found that under highly symmetric situations, and if in that situation if 3-4 conditions are met with, then you can find out the electric field in that situation in couple of steps rather than doing complex mathematical calculations. So humne insulating sphere spherical shell ke liye humne nikala at a point inside and outside. Then for a non-conducting solid sphere ke liye humne calculate kiya tha. Then inside the cavity of a solid sphere, that also we calculated. Then for different line charge, okay, infinite sheet, all that we did with the help of this. Then we did certain properties of conductor. Okay, that we finished yesterday. Now, मुझे बताना क्या हमने कल किया था.
बाकी है
ये क्वेश्चन हमने किए थे, ये ड्रिल 9-10 के क्वेश्चन थे
सर, बाकी है.
ठीक है, तो चलो स्टार्ट करते हैं. सो यू हैव 1 मिनट टू थिंक ओवर इट एंड देन टेल मी व्हाट द आंसर. So there are two principles that we involved in this question. First is that charge will remain conserved. Second is because of the conducting wire, potential of both the spheres will become equal. Okay, so first is total charge is minus 2q in the system. That will also remain same after redistribution, after they become equipotential. Then you wrote the expression for their individual potentials, equated them and found out that q1 is 0 and q2 is minus 2q. Okay, without it. समझ में आ गया क्या गलती कर रहे थे ब्रज हर्ष तुम लोग?
हाँ सर.
ठीक है ना, कोई बहुत हाई फाई क्वेश्चन नहीं है ये, क्वेश्चन आईआईटी जेई में आएगा. ठीक है, तुमको टफ लगेगा बट टफ नहीं है, तुमको बेसिक रूल्स समझ में आने चाहिए. तो बेसिक लॉज है वो अप्लाई करने, टफ क्वेश्चंस करने से सिलेक्शन नहीं होता है, सिलेक्शन होता है एप्लीकेशन ऑफ कांसेप्ट. नाउ वी हैव अनदर टू प्रॉब्लम्स that we will do after some time, but let's first understand the concept of self energy. Okay, so what is self energy? If there is a charge which is distributed in space, kya hai charge? Q hai. Theek hai na, already itna build ho chuka hai. Because of that charge, there is a potential of the sphere. That potential will be given by KQ by R. Yes or no? Okay. Now, when you add on another additional charge DQ, so that its charge now becomes Q plus DQ. So this additional charge that has been brought from infinity has to do what against this potential? Potential at infinity is zero and potential of the surface is kq by r. So work done by the external agent in adding additional charge dq is dq into v, potential difference, which is kq dq by r. Are you samajh mein? Now the total work done will be stored as the potential energy of the system, which is nothing but self energy. So this is self energy, which will be given by k by r q dq integral. Initially the value of q is zero, finally the value of q is capital Q. So your answer will be kq squared by 2. So the charge is distributed uniformly across the volume. Total volume of a sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. So there is a term known as charge density, which is total charge q upon 4 by 3 pi r cube. What is r? This is r. Okay, final radius is r. Now to create that kind of configuration, I choose to take elements which are spherical shell. So ye mera ek element hai. ये क्या है? चार्ज एलिमेंट है, ठीक है ना? इस पे चार्ज है dq. So this dq charge is what? Rho into elemental volume. ये एक छोटा सा, you can think of it as a paste of charge. आपने already r radius का, small r radius का एक sphere बन चुका था, उसके ऊपर आप एक छोटा सा dq charge का smearing कर रहे हो, तिलक लगा रहे हो उसको, या उस पे कुछ वो बना रहे हो, ठीक है? Paste कर रहे हो ऐसा कुछ. So that will be density times the volume. What is the volume of that small elemental shell? 4 pi r square dr. Surface area of the sphere is 4 pi r square. Uspe apne dr thickness ka ek paste lagaya. So this will be the volume. Usko density se multiply kar diya. So now your dq is q divided by 4 by 3 pi r cube. 4 pi r square dr. This 4 pi cancels out. So your dq is 3q upon r cube times r square dr. So this is what is available to you. Now this charge has been brought from infinity.